Told you, too open. Too open.
Since you'd love to see that first one go in, especially at home.
Malik also an outstanding shooter, a tough cover as a lefty in the backcourt. That one does fall for Kyrie Thomas.
I just love his game. He plays so much under control. He takes the shots that are given to him. There's so much pressure when you're forwards and big and knock down shots. It just opens it up for the guard in front of the backcourt player.
Foster stays with it. He's got such a quick first step. Jay Wright told me today prior to the game, no peel and an opportunity to run here for Creighton. More of that from Thomas means we may have a good one, even without Ronnie Harrell.
For 14 from behind the arc, so come with a guy that's been on fire after a little slump.
Malik on the wing. He's got a great stroke. No one ever called a right-hander crafty. This kid's crafty.
Well, he's crafty, but he's confident. You can see it from there. You're going to have to limit something. And you have to figure it out. He's going to force Villanova to shoot another jump shot by Kyrie.
Well, in talking with Greg McDermott yesterday, he said you got to score first and foremost.
Yep.
And it's pulled down by Davion Mintz.
Yeah, wonderful defensive possession that time by Creighton. Oh. Take advantage.
There's the blow-by. There's the quickness. He's got checks. No one's faster than Marcus Foster with the rock. Booth. Rejected by Mintz. Kyrie. Well, he has been spot on here early. Four for four from downtown for Thomas.
Bound as it goes crying off the front rim.
Look at that stop and go. Look at that step and go. He's got a different gear, Marcus Foster, and you better stay with him.
Well, with Marcus Foster, quite honestly, you're going to try to pick him up early. Because if you allow him to get ahead of steam going downhill and he sees a gap, the strength in his body, the ability to create and get in between the gaps is going to be tough for anybody to stop him.
DiVincenzo can't get it to go. That ended, by the way, that bucket, a 7-0 run. Thomas. Hello. How do you do? Time out, Villanova.
Marcus Foster getting it done on the offensive end is the reason why he's the leading scorer. The Big East. And he, with the inside pivot, exploded right to the basket.
Oh, the lefty! Finger roll off the glass and one.
High pick.
Foster falling away. The seventh lead change of the afternoon.
Stopping 1-on-1.
Another turnover. Numbers. Davion. Oh, yes, and one.
Got Josie Bronson right here trying to make a pass to Pascal. And again, in transition, no one stopped Davion Mintz. Able to get right to the basket and talking about a scoring machine. Sometimes the guy's just good. You know what I mean? And closing out the last 2 minutes is paramount in having momentum when you come out in the second half.
Nice pass! A Sunday best dish into Foster, who electrically attacked the 10. Here we go. Step back three. Yes, at the buzzer.
Tim, you're talking about closing out of the half. Get it to your main man, Marcus Foster. I may not be able to beat you off the dribble. A little step back, 3-point shot. No problem, I got this. Creighton closing the gap on the number three team in the country. And again, it's great defense, but better hold, my friend.
Is that a clear out or is that a clear out?
Oh, it's a clear out all the way.
Oh boy, 40 to 38.
Bit of a rest, and he was happy with Mitch Ballack in his first career start.
He should be, and again, he was already conscious of those seconds that he could buy before the under 12 and the under 8 timeout. Right away, Thomas off the entry, gets it. Mintz for three.
Has a little mismatch inside.
Foster rattles it home, and he's feeling it. Absolutely feeling it. Foster with his first points of this half. And the Villanova lead down to one.
Transfer from Kansas State. Haskell back in the game with three.
Edwardson on the alley-oop. The Aussie says, good day, mate.
First.
Yeah, McDermott wants to get the ball back around to Kyrie.
Yeah, he does.
Because he had a mismatch with Spillman, but there it is.
He wanted it. Nice pass. Epperson off the glass. A 12-4 Blue Jays run. Here comes the crowd in Omaha.
With Villanova.
Ballack end-to-end to Epperson again. This kid is coming out of his shell right before your very eyes on Big Game Saturday on Fox.
I told you, Fred.
Well, the reformation of the Big East is gone.
How about a little change to defense, a little zone? Great recognition of getting Kyrie Thomas the ball. Extended free throw line to Turnbull.
Fred McDermott said this was the best offensive team Villanova's had, including the national championship team. I agree with you. I do.
Nice power move by Kyrie Thomas. The only difference with
being able to keep them fully gassed up, so to speak. The substitution.
Egner. Nice little floater from the baseline. Off the pass from Bout.
They're outscoring their opponents about 16 points a game at neutral sites are on the road. Other four teams that have done that in the past, Tim, have all gone on to the Final Four. So, rare air here.
Oh! Epperson again! You gotta get him the rock near the rim. Beautiful lob inside.
1 minute and 24 seconds for him on the bench today.
Finds Foster on the wing. Callen! Here they come. Here they come. Timeout.
Coming out of timeout. Attention to detail. Attacking the zone defense. Find the gap. Throw it up to the 6'11". Blair let him dunk it himself. And then a miscue by Phil Booth trying to go for the steal. And Marcus Foster is like, finally able to knock it in.
Brunson finally got his attention. And he launched the shot. That's the sixth team foul on Villanova.
Foster!
Told you he knew.
Gillespie. Rebound to Mintz. Another opportunity for the lead on this possession. Ballack. And he's fouled.
You don't know what you're going to get when you're playing an individual like Epperson who hasn't played a lot of minutes. You really don't know what you're going to get. Kind of give you what you're looking for, especially on the inside. Oh, defensive rebounding. Excellent defense. Now he's scoring the basketball as well.
In conference play.
Extra possessions.
Brunson. Count it. And a foul on Epperson.
Here, dude, right there.
But also, great teams figure out ways on the road to just get extra possession. The kick out, the tap out by Eric Paschal, out to Jalen Brunson, who just refused at that time to give the ball up and let his team be disappointed. Brunson has Nova's last 10 points, and my goodness, McDermott, there's really not too much you can do about Brunson getting to the basket, finishing with his own hand.
And you're watching the best player in college basketball right there.
Without a doubt.
I mean, he is.
Pick and roll coming here, Tim.
Gotta try to win with your best.
Palick wide open. Hello, how do you do? The Blue Jays are being hurt from timeout Villanova.
Well, on that last defensive possession, we talked about Brunson. Poor decision here by going for the steal instead of being solid. Opened it up for Mitchell Ballack to just square his body. The lefty came through big time. Again, the decision to try to go for the steal by Brunson cost Villanova that three-point shot.
Oh, he's loving it. They're better having this position than this guy right here.
What a regather to Bridges. Ball is loose. Blue Jays have it. Kyrie Thomas is fouled. 10.4 remaining.
Shot from the wing right here.
Right.
And I thought.
Oh, Thomas missed it.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy. And they're going to get Foster. Sometimes you can try a little too hard.
Free throw line 76%.
DiVincenzo 70. They can still tie it with this one. You think you might ice him here with a timeout?
I would, but how many to have that they have? He may want to keep it in his back pocket just in case.
Overtime is perhaps in the back of his mind. He's got two left.
Push it after this make. He's going right at it.
72 all. This possession
out
for the win and a clear out.
Foster rejected. We are going to overtime.
Wow. Well, you put the ball in your best scorer's hand, Marcus Foster, on the best defender there is in the Big East. And not a bad play by Foster, just a better defensive play by Bridges. And I also think that with, I think that's DiVincenzo right here, the eyes are down a little bit by Foster, which allows Bridges to catch up and get this shot. You see, if he wasn't there, he was able to get right to the basket.
He knows his best player got the look. He's taking a long look at that shot because Gillespie grazed the front iron. Thomas hits the switch to Brunson, takes him downtown. Right down Broadway there. Set. All of this without Ronnie Harrell available today. Paschal. Ballack ooping, there he is.
How about the patience that time of Mitch Ballack has proved that he can shoot the ball off the dribble.
Paschal using his strength to go right at the chest of the freshman.
Why not using his quickness to pick and roll again?
Mince, little teardrop. Who did the Chimso? Had it, lost it, and Mince followed up.
And those are the kind of plays right there for Creighton that you need. Missed opportunity for deep.
Paschal again, right back at him. Nothing doing this time. High pick and roll being run. Well defended, but there is a switch. The timeout taken by McIntyre. He had two, decides to use one right here.
Epperson making his presence felt, just throw it up. Partner, I got your back.
Good day, mate.
To take advantage of transition, but then you pull it back out and run your offense. Get your pick and roll. That's what this is up here for you.
I think that's what he had in mind. Roger Ayers spots a foul on a Rudolph that time. It goes against Stephen Kinzo. He was not going to allow Epperson to get close to the rack that time.
Well, it's a smart play. That time, he tried to be sneaky here and put his body right into him without really throwing him off. You know, but listen, I mean, that's what you got to do sometimes. You got to make sure that he doesn't get the rebound and put him to the free throw line to make him earn his two.
Oh, boy. Love Jay's reactions. Not many free throws for this young man. Not a very good free throw shooter.
That didn't look like it.
That was then. This is now. And this kid is having his coming out party.
He stepped right up to the free throw line, took a couple dribbles, and said, I got this.
He was 1 out of 6 coming in tonight. He's 2 out of 2 now.
But it's amazing how confidence spurs that, because he's been playing so well throughout the course of the game, in particular late in the second half. Now he's beaming with confidence and gets to the free throw line and knocks him in.
Oh, yeah, the ratings in Cincinnati are going to be awful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Implications on this is tremendous.
Mintz got away. Nice pass to Ballack. 60 seconds left in the OT.
Hold on.
And right now, it is a Creighton coronation that's in play as a quick possession arrow goes to Villanova after the tie-in. But only 2.5 left. And look at the head coach. He's grinning from ear to ear.
It'd be a good time to ask Greg to take us out to eat. Yeah, pick up the bill.
I've got friends here. I'm already taking
Of course you do, Timmy. Yeah,
I've got them in Philadelphia, too.
Okay, well, I'm going to be selfish.
They waited for a long time after that Xavier loss and a controversial play, but today it doesn't come down to that. The Creighton Blue Jays get that much-needed signature win in overtime, 89-83. That's our final.